Hi there! Today we will be showing you the basics of entomology. Disclaimer, all insects were found post-mortem. If you are under the age of 18, please make sure you have adult supervision since we will be dealing with chemicals and sharp objects. Make sure to watch the full video before starting, and also, be aware that this could be a 2-week process or longer. Now, let's get into it. First off, we found our specimen, and we were going to take it to place it into the jar and— wait a minute. Is that wet?
Kinda. First, you need to get a glass jar, then place a damp paper towel in it. Then, you add rubbing alcohol onto the paper towel. Just enough to drench a paper towel, not flood it. Then, you cover it with something to seal the container, either a lid or plastic wrap.
Now, let's resume. In this next part, we tried opening the wings just a slightly bit, and we got it to balance onto the in the jar. And like I said before, we kind of tried opening it just so it could, you know, ease into fully opening. And after this, we just closed the jar up, and we left our insects in them for about 1 to 5 days. So they're in the jars, so you can't see them right now, but basically the specimen that we used was one monarch butterfly, a carpenter bee, and then we also used an African black beetle.
First off, you have to get your insect, some pins, a spreading board, wax paper, and some sort of weight. For example, we use rocks. Once you have all your materials, put your insect on the spreading board and carefully pin the center of it to the board. If your insect has large wings, spread them, put wax paper on them, and pin close to the wings, not impaling them in any way. When pinning the body, we pin the thorax, but if you have an insect like the African black beetle, do the cross-pinning technique. After you get your pinning done, you should leave them out for another 1 to 5 days.
Okay, so now it's after the 1 to 5 days, and we are removing the pins. A thing that is like a helpful tip is that we twisted and then pulled up the pins so we didn't break anything. For this next part, you have to get an epoxy kit, a silicone mold, and some decorations to put in with your specimen. For example, we use dried flowers. Also, if epoxy does not come with a spatula or mixing cups, you can use popsicle sticks or throwaway measuring cup. Do not use any regular mixing cup or spatula since the resin will not come out. For mine, I used a heart-shaped mold, some flowers for decorations, and I was going to use the butterfly to put in as the insect. This one was Bub's mold. We poured the resin halfway in the measuring cup and filled the rest with hardener. You have to mix for at least 3 minutes and make sure to scrape the sides and bottom. Next, we spread it and poured it evenly into the mold. After adding in the epoxy, we added in bugs and decorations.
toothpicks to stick down some of the decorations in the mold. After that, we poured the rest of the epoxy onto the mold.
Go for it.
Thank you guys for watching. We hope this taught you a bit more about entomology and gave you a fun project to do while we are all quarantined. Stay safe out there. Goodbye.